In the previous class, we have studied about Euler's theorem. Today, let us study about Bernoulli's theorem. The statement Bernoulli's theorem goes like this. It states that in a steady ideal flow of an incompressible fluid, the total energy at any point of the fluid is constant. I'll repeat it. It states that in a steady and ideal flow of an incompressible fluid, the total energy at any point of the fluid is constant. This is what is Bernoulli's theorem. What is the total energy? These energies per unit weight of the fluid are, first one is pressure energy. Pressure energy, which is equals to P divided by rho into G. This is the pressure energy. Next is kinetic energy. Kinetic energy that is equals to V square divided by 2G. Next, datum energy. This is equals to Z. These three are the energies per unit weight of fluid. Energies per unit weight of the fluid. So mathematically, we can write the Bernoulli's theorem as summation of all these energies, that is the first one is pressure energy, that is P divided by rho g, plus V square divided by 2g, that is kinetic energy, plus datum energy, that is equals to Z. These three are constant. This is what is Bernoulli's theorem. So now let us derive the Bernoulli's theorem. How to derive Bernoulli's theorem? Bernoulli's theorem we will derive from the Euler's equation of motion. We have derived Euler's equation of motion in previous classes. That is del P divided by rho plus G divided by dz plus V into dV is equals to 0. See, here this Euler equation we have derived by considering a small fluid element. Okay, now to get the Bernoulli's equation, we have to integrate this Euler's equation of motion. How we will get? Bernoulli's equation can be obtained by integrating Euler's equation of motion. Okay, Bernoulli's equation can be obtained by integrating Euler's equation of motion. Now, what is Euler's equation of motion? We have derived it in the previous class, that is del P divided by rho plus G into dz plus V into dV is equals to 0. This is Euler's equation. Okay, integrate this. That is integral of del P divided by rho plus integral of G dz plus integral of V dV is equals to constant. This del rho, integral of del rho is P divided by rho plus g into integral of dz is z g into z plus integral of v into dv, that is equals to integral of v is v square divided by 2 is equals to constant. Divide this equation by g. I will get p divided by rho into g plus z plus v square divided by 2g is equals to constant. Very simple. Now let us see what are the assumptions that we made, okay, while deriving this Bernoulli's equation. So while deriving this Bernoulli's equation, we have assumed that the very first one is the fluid is ideal, right? While studying the Bernoulli's theorem, we have seen that what it says, study ideal and incompressible fluid. So here you have to write all these things. That is what the assumptions are. The fluid is ideal. So what ideal fluid means? It means that its viscosity is zero, right? That is, its viscosity is zero. Next, second assumption is the flow is steady. Next one is the flow is incompressible. These three assumptions we will get in statement of the theorem itself. The next one is the flow is irrotational. These four are the assumptions made while deriving this Bernoulli's equation. Okay. So you may expect the question something like this. State Bernoulli's theorem for a steady flow of an incompressible fluid. Derive an expression for Bernoulli's equation from the first principle. First principles means you have to start from this very first one, Euler's equation. This one, it is there now. First principles means what is the complete force, what is the total force in x direction, which is the combination of gravitational force plus pressure force plus viscous force. This is P, viscous force, and the force due to turbulence and force due to compressibility. Okay, and what is the Euler equation? How we got the Euler equation? Okay, Euler equation is for when the flow is ideal. We know that when the flow is ideal, its viscous force will be equal to zero. Okay, so then the equation becomes like this. We have taken this one. So first derive Euler equation. After deriving the Euler equation, you derive the Bernoulli's equation. The complete thing you have to do if they ask you to derive from the first principles. Okay, so this is how we have to derive the Bernoulli's equation. Now let us look into few problems where we use Bernoulli's theorem. Okay, Bernoulli's theorem, and what are the applications of Bernoulli's theorem? These things we will see. We will look into very simple problems which will comprise of continuity equation and also the Bernoulli's theorem. And afterwards, we will look into the next topic after these problems. See here, the water is flowing through a pipe having a diameter. The water is flowing through a pipe having diameters 20 centimeters and 10 centimeters at sections 1 and 2 respectively. sections 1 and 2 respectively. The rate of flow through pipe is 35 liters per second. The section 1 is 6 meters above datum and section 2 is 4 meters above datum. If the pressure at section 1 is 39.24 newton per centimeter square, find the intensity of pressure at section 2. This is how the problem is. For this one, first we will draw a sketch. The water is flowing through a pipe having 20 centimeters at section 1 and 10 centimeters at section 2, right? So that means solution, that means diameter at section 1, is equals to 20 centimeters, and diameter at section 2 is equals to 10 centimeters. This says that we will convert this into the SI units, so that is equals to 0.2 meters. If this is this one, then what will be the area? Pi by 4 d square, that is equals to pi by 4 point 2 square. Right, this is equals to 0.0314 meter square. This is area of the cross section 1. Next, the same way, this is equals to 0.1 meters, 10 centimeters is equals to A2 is equals to pi by 4, 0.1 square. This is equals to how much will this will be? 0.00785 meter square. Okay. Then if we consider this as the datum, the rate of flow through pipe is 35 liters per second, that is Q is equals to 35 liters per second. Q is equals to 35 liters per second. That is equals to 35 divided by 1000 is equals to 0.035 meter cube per second. Converting liters to meter cube. Okay. That is equals to, this is the datum line. The first one, okay, this is at, the section 1 is 6 meters above. Section 1 is 6 meters above and the section 2 is 4 meters above. This is section 2. This is 4 meters above. Section 2 is 4 meters above. So, like this. Okay. If this diameter is 20 centimeters and this is 10 centimeters. So, it is a tapering section like this. It is a tapering section like this. That means Z1 is datum line as we have discussed. Z1 is equals to 6 meters and Z2 is equals to 4 meters. Z2 is equals to 4 meters. Okay, now why this Q discharge they have given? We know that Q discharge is equals to A1 B1 is equals to A2 V2. A1 V1 is equals to A2 V2. And we also know that V1 is equals to discharge divided by A1. Do you remember? Velocity at one point is equals to Q divided by discharge divided by A1. They have given it as this is equals to 0.035 meter cube per second divided by area 1. This is equals to 0.0314. This will give us the velocity at section 1 in meter square per second. Right? Meters per second. I am sorry. Meters per second. Velocity in meters per second. So, what is V1 here? If we calculate, do some maths here. 1.114 meters per second. The same way we will calculate A2, V2 also. We can follow the same method also, or you can even take this A1 V1 is equals to A2 V2. Anyhow, somehow we can calculate. So we will follow the same formula, that is V2 is equals to discharge divided by area A2, that is equals to 0.035 divided by area of second section is 0.00785, and when we do this one we will get the value that as 4.456 meters per second. 4.456 meters per second. Now what do we want? We want here we have to find out the intensity at pressure of pressure at section 2. That means we want, he has given P1 section, right? Pressure at section 1, that is P1 is equals to 39.24 Newton per centimeter square. Once again convert this to meters, 39.24 into 10 to the power of minus 4 Newton per meter square. 39.24 into 10 to the power of 10 to the power of 4 Newton per meter square. Okay. So, from the Bernoulli's equation, by using the Bernoulli's equation, okay, we can calculate, that is, we know that P1 divided by rho into G plus V1 square divided by 2G plus Z1 is equals to P2 divided by rho into G plus V2 square divided by 2G plus Z2, right? See here, because the fluid flowing is water, we know the density of water is 1000, so P1 it is 39.24 into 10 to the power of 4 divided by 1000 into 9.81 plus V1 is equals to 1.114 square divided by 2 into 9.81 plus Z1 is equals to 6 meters. 6 is equals to P2. This is what we are supposed to calculate. P2 divided by 1000 into 9.81 plus V2 is equals to 4.456 square divided by 2 into 9.81 plus Z2 is equals to 4 meters. This is equals to 4. From this one equation, we can calculate P2. Okay. When we do this mathematical simplification, we will get P2 value. So, P2 we will get it here as 40.27 Newton per centimeter square. So, to do this sum, we should know the formula, that is what is discharge means. Okay, Q is equals to A1 into V1 and A2 into V2. Okay, and we should also know the Bernoulli's equation. The same way we can solve few more problems. That problems we will look in the next class.